ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमः
ओम
भगवते
भगवते
वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम
ओम नमो
नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं
नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं।
नरं चैव नरोत्तमं
नरं चैव नरोत्तमं।
देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं
देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं।
ततो जयमुदीरयेत्।
ततो जय उति उदिरेत्।
नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु
नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु
नित्यं भागवत सेवया
नित्यं भागवत सेवया
भगवती उत्तम श्लोके
भगवति उत्तम श्लोके
भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी।
भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी।
Reading from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 17, title, The Divisions of Faith. And today, we are going to read verse number 17. Shraddhaya paraya taptam.
Shraddhaya paraya taptam.
Tapasta trividham naraye.
Tapasta trividham naraye.
Afala kanksha vir yukte.
Afala kanksha.
स्वात्विकं परिचक्षते श्रद्धाया परया ताप्तम् तपस्तत्त्रिविधं
नरैः
अफलाकांक्षभिर्युक्तैः सात्विकं परिचक्षते
सात्विकं परिचक्षते।
एनी प्रभुजी और माताजी वुड लाइक टू लीड?
नो।
श्रद्धया परया तप्तम्।
श्रद्धया परया तप्तम्
तपस्तत्त्रिविधं नरे
तपस्तत्त्रिविधं नरे
अफणा अफणा कांक शिभिर युक्ते
अफलाकांक्षभिर युक्ते
सात्विकं परिचक्षते
सात्विकं परिचक्षते
श्रद्धया परया तप्तम्
श्रद्धया परया तप्तम्
तपस्तत्त्रिविधं नरे
तपस्तत्त्रिविधं नरे
अफलाकांक्षभिर युक्ते
सात्विकं
परिक्षसते
सात्विकं परिचक्षते। वर्ड बाय वर्ड मीनिंग सॉरी गो अहेड।
श्रद्धया परया तप्तम्
श्रद्धया परया तप्तम्
तपस्तत्त्रिविधं नरे
तपस्तत्त्रिविधं नरे
अफलाकांक्षिभिर्युक्ते
अफलाकांक्षभिर्युक्ते
सात्विकं परिचक्षते
सात्विकं परिचक्षते। वर्ड बाय वर्ड मीनिंग श्रद्धाया विथ फेथ
श्रद्धाया विथ फेथ
पराया ट्रांसेंडेंटल
Paraya, transcendental.
Taptam, executed.
Taptam,
executed. Tapa, austerity.
Tapa.
Tapa, austerity.
Tat, that.
Tat, that.
Trividham, of three kinds.
Trividham, of three kinds.
Narai, by men.
Narai, by men.
Afala, akankshivhi.
Afala, akankshivhi.
Who are without desires for fruits?
Who are without desires for fruits?
Yuktai, engaged.
Yuktai,
engaged.
Sattvikam.
Sattvikam.
In the mode of goodness.
In the mode of goodness.
Parichakshate.
Parichakshate.
Is called.
Parichakshate. Is called.
Translation. Translation wise, Divine Grace is Sivaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Swami Prabhupada Ki Jai. This threefold austerity.
This threefold austerity
performed with transcendental faith.
performed with transcendental faith
by men,
by men,
not expecting material benefits, but engaged only for the sake of the Supreme.
But engaged only for the sake of the Supreme
is called austerity in goodness. As the next two verses are related, I put the translation and purport. Anybody would like to read this page?
Translation: penance performed out of pride and for the sake of gaining respect, honor, and worship is said to be in the mode of passion. It is neither stable nor permanent. Purport: sometimes penance and austerity are executed to attract people and receive honor, respect, and worship from others. Persons in the mode of passion arrange to be worshipped by subordinates and let them wash their feet and offer riches. Such arrangements, artificially made by the performance of penances, are considered to be in the mode of passion. The results are temporary. They can be continued for some time, but they are not permanent.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Anyone else would like to read the next verse, translation and purport?
Penance performed out of foolishness with self-torture or to destroy or to injure others is said to be in the mode of ignorance. Purport: there are instances of foolish penance undertaken by demons like Hiranyakashipu, who austere penance to become immoral and kill the demigods. He prayed to Brahma for such things, but ultimately he was killed by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To undergo penances for something which is impossible is certainly in the mode of ignorance.
Thank you, Prabhu. Let's all chant together. Ajnana timirandasya jnana janashalakaya chakshur militam yena sasmay sri gurave namo sri chaitanya manovistam sthapitam yena bhutale swayam rupa kadamaiham dadati swapadantikam bandeham sri guru syuta pada kamalam sri guru vaishnavamsha tirupam sagrajatam sahagana raghunatham vitam tam sajivam sadvitam savadhutam parijana sahit tam krishna chaitanya devam sri radha krishna padan sagana lalita sri shakha vitamsha he krishna karuna sindhu dina bandhu jagatpate gopesha gopika kanta radha kanta namastute tapta kanchana gaurangi radhe vandavaneshwari vishvanasute devi pranamami hari priye vancha kalpataru vyasya kripa sindhu vaivacha patitanam pavanevyo vaishnavevyo namo namo jai shri krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda shri advaita gadadhar shivasa adi gaura bhakta vrinda hare krishna hare krishna 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 hare 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 rama hare rama 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 hare hare lachal nivasa nityaya pramatmane balabhadra subhadra abhyam jagannatha itanam. So thank you so much for joining this wonderful sangha where we discussed verse by verse Bhagavad Gita, a systematic study of Bhagavad Gita, so that we build on the case what the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, is posing in front of Arjuna, as Arjuna is very much confused and he really didn't want to fight. He left his bow. So in this verse, Krishna is talking about austerity or penance or tapasya, as you sometimes, and you today in this verse you read, Krishna is talking about tapasya, which is tapas. Tapas means austerity. So last time, Krishna gave a brief description of tapasya, austerity, wherein you need to control your body in the form of worshipability, mind, how to become austere in mind, and words, BMW. We spoke about it, you discussed. So last three verses, 17.14, 15.16, was about Krishna discussing about the definitions of austerity, wherein you control your body by worshipping, by controlling your body, controlling your mind, 14.15 and 14.16, around words. So body, mind, words, BMW. So now Krishna is applying those principles of the definition of austerity on the modes. Modes means mode of goodness, which is 17.17, passion 17.18, and 17.19, mode of ignorance. So very systematic. Krishna has spoken Bhagavad Gita in the most systematic fashion. If somebody wants to write a book and wants to write a book for his benefit or her benefit, he or she should write based on how Krishna is posing the conformance, definition, principles, and then applying it on the subject one after other. So it's a very nice formation in which he's trying to convince the greatest devotee of the world, Arjuna. So this verse talks, and the next two verses talks about austerity in modes. So if you have an x-axis, y-axis, you put austerity, you know, how a person should be austere in mode of goodness, sattvic, passion, rajasic, ignorance, tamasic. And Krishna is giving the definition. So very simple verse. So if you study Bhagavad Gita, that's why Srila Prabhupada wants us not to read Bhagavad Gita. He wanted us to study Bhagavad Gita. The reason why Bhagavad Gita has to be studied is if you dissect Bhagavad Gita and understand the simple principles laid out in the most nice and articulate way, you'll realize you'll have a lot of clarity in your life as to how you should lead your life. So we have these three verses: austerity in mode of goodness, passion, and ignorance. So with that said, I just wanted to put forth this picture, what you're seeing here. As you can see, there are some people who are doing hunger strike on the bottom right of the screen. That hamari mangi puri karo. That means, you know, just fulfill our things, and we want some individual benefits, and based on that, you have hartal, wherein there is austerity happening. People are, you know, leaving their jobs, leaving their families. Sometimes they're doing hunger strike, and they're sitting in a corner of a street, and they're doing hunger strike. This, as per the definition led by Krishna, is nothing but mode of total ignorance. Because this mode of doing strike, hunger strike, austerity, tapasya, hunger strike, not eating food. See, whenever you are detaching something from your day-to-day life, that is some form of austerity, whether it is a minimal form of austerity or a maximum form of austerity. So that is nothing but mode of ignorance, total ignorance, as you can see, because most of the time these people are brainwashed into believing something without having a good understanding of the scriptural references, and they will come and do hartal for you in a politicized atmosphere. So this, in the transcendental knowledge, any form of human politics in comparison to the transcendental knowledge as put forth by Krishna is nothing but the most ignorant, austere thing you can think of. So whenever we have a chance to recognize austerity, we should not fall victim to these kind of little petty politics, because that will take us away from the basic transcendental understanding which Bhagavad Gita is referring to. Now let's take a step up, wherein we think about mode of passion, wherein in order to get something, you have to give up and do something. As you can see on the right side, Ravana is doing tapa. Ravana is standing in one leg and, you know, lifting his hand with his 10 heads, you know, 20 hands. And he is doing austerity. He's asking for a boon that, and when the boon is about to be satisfied, he says, you know, I should not be killed by a divine personality like Deva or a demoniac personality like Rakshasa, and I should be so powerful. He did everything possible. He stood in one leg, you know, recited mantras to get the benefit of so that he could prolong his life. These are demoniac mentalities. These are mentalities wherein you are basically doing something for your passion. And when you're exactly doing that, he forgot about a possibility that a god can come in the form of a human being like a Nara, and he can kill him. So that was the level. When you are in the mode of passion, you forget so many things. And Ravana forgot to ask for that boon. And eventually Lord Ram went, crossed the ocean and killed him in his own area, in his own locality. So this is the height of heroism when you think about this pastime wherein the Lord is unleashing. And he's not unleashing with a great army of, archers and this and that. No, he's just going with a bunch of monkeys and bears to really kill the topmost strong demoniac personality who once upon a time, he's a Brahmana. That's what we spoke some time back, that when this Brahminical person with so much of knowledge, they resort to demoniac qualities, they become Brahmarakshasa. They mean they become very, 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 very powerful. And in order to get rid of them, you need the Supreme Personality of Godhead to come and unleash in his place so that all our life we are taught a lesson that how and why we should not do austerity in passion. Now, let's take a step up. And here, Krishna is using the word yukta. Yukta. You all read this, yukta. Yukta means yukta, engaged. And you might have heard in ISKCON a very common term called yukta vairagya. Yukta vairagya is a very, very common term. And if you hear Malati Mataji, one of the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, he would say that when Srila Prabhupada taught them how to make rotis, they did not have the rolling sticks from India. At the time, 1966, 67, 68, the Krishna conscious movement was in very much infancy and there was no belan at the time. So what Malati Mataji once mentioned in a class, that she saw a bottle, some bottle, it may have been a bottle used for the wrong reasons. He picked up a bottle, washed it, and used that bottle to do flattening of the kneading of the bread, and then eventually made rotis under the directive of Srila Prabhupada. That is called Yukta Vairagya. Using anything and everything, Yukta, Krishna is using, engaged. Engaging anything and everything, staying in the confines of detaching yourself from the material, staying in family life, staying in the life you lead, staying with your families, going to the office, but not getting entangled into the prajalpa, into the parties, but staying there and still leading Krishna consciousness. That is Yukta Vairagya, which Krishna is using. Aphala Akankshibhi, that means Akankshi means to desire something. Aphala means without any desires. So without desires, engaging something for the pleasure of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, staying in the confines of your day-to-day life is transcendental. For transcendental achievements, you don't have to go to Himalayas. You don't have to go to caves. You don't have to go to riverbeds. In the place where you are, you could still meditate on the Lord, Smaranam. You could still think about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, do service for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So austerity in the mode of goodness, right here. Srila Prabhupada, waking up at 3 o'clock, writing translation of Srimad Bhagavatam, doing the chanting around Tulsi Maharani, and then going out on a morning walk with his devotees to make sure whether the devotees have understood his principles or not. Right in the morning, when people are just sleeping, people are just enraged, in the day-to-day lives and are totally blind and are sleeping till 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. Nowadays, a lot of people are waking up at 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, which is unthinkable at those days. And Srila Prabhupada waking up at 3 a.m., austere, leading a bunch of devotees to deliver Krishna consciousness and getting rid of sleeping in the morning, not thinking about enjoying sleeping as most of the people nowadays are. So that is the austerity in the mode of goodness. So you see right here in this picture, if you think about austerity in the mode of ignorance, you have the hunger strike going on in the bottom right. Austerity in the mode of passion in order to get something. I'm trying to do something to get something. This doing something to getting something is like a business. You give something, you get something. Here, Ravana, standing in one leg, one of the greatest brahmanas, he was one of the most powerful personalities, but misusing that for his benefit. That is mode of passion. Doing something, doing some austere activities, but for the purpose of individual benefit is going to take you down. But if you end up doing something without any personal advantage. Many people, they will end up doing a lot of things, but behind the scene, they want some benefit at the end. They need some position, they need some money, they need some promotion, this, that. But here, Srila Prabhupada is explaining Lord Krishna's words by saying, whenever you have no personal interest, you do not have any enthusiasm to get fame, but still you are doing some activity for the pleasure of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. What did the gopis had in Vrindavan? They had nothing. They just want to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But this is a very simple concept. But in this material world, we are so much occupied with benefits. ROI is a big term in our day-to-day life. We won't end up doing anything unless we have some personal benefit. With that said, we cannot understand the simple concept of devotional service as to what it would need to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So the austerity, the right austerity, in the mode of goodness is performed with the faith that whatever the Supreme Personality of Godhead is going to give us is going to be prasad to us. Whether he gives us happiness, we take it. Whether he gives us unhappiness, we take it as his remnant. And not expecting material benefits and engaged only for the sake of Supreme is called austerity in goodness. So whenever you end up helping somebody in the street corner, if you start thinking that you'll get some benefit at the end of the day, what good is the benefit? It has become a business for you. But whenever you do, as Krishna is saying, without expecting material benefits, but engaged only for the sake of suffering, that is austerity in goodness. And anytime you are performing something out of pride and for the sake of gaining respect, honor, and worship is said to be in the mode of passion, which is what Ravana is doing. And any austerity performed out of foolishness, like the hunger strike you saw, with self-torture or to destroy or injure others. When during the strikes, a lot of people get killed as well. Said to be in the mode of goodness. These wars, the strikes have no benefit to anyone. People get killed, they kill people. It's in pure ignorance. They sometimes don't know what they're trying to do. So very nicely explained by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We can go on and on and on. But when you think about the austerity, whenever you're trying to donate something, whenever you're trying to do something good to someone, use these principles which the Supreme Personality of Godhead is so nicely explaining. And in doing so, you'll understand and whenever you apply it and you stay more time in Krishna consciousness, you realize how much apt, how much relevant these concepts are, because you are basically following the footsteps of what is being told by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, what is uttered by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And when you end up following the path laid out by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, you will be very thankful that by association of devotees, you understood, you read, you studied Bhagavad Gita, and eventually that is helping you stay happy in whatever you do, not for the sake of money, not for the sake of fame, but for the sake of serving something. It is mentioned, University of Pennsylvania, they did a research study where they gave $20 to all the students. Students go, do something, and come back. We'll ask you some questions. Everybody went, they spent it in whatever ways. They found that the person who didn't end up spending anything on himself or herself was the most happiest person. And that is what Krishna is saying. Staying austere in the mode of goodness without expecting anything in the return is 17.17 for you devotees. So more we take these words into our life and apply it, without someday it will come. We most of the time in this material world, we are very much in the return of investment principle, and we are not going to do anything unless we know that we get something in return. But Krishna consciousness is a totally different perspective. It gives you the life's lessons wherein you are benefiting in the long haul, not momentarily, not just ROI in the next 7 days or next 14 days. This is going to help you for your life once you understand these concepts. So if you think about this verse, if you think about this picture, wherein Krishna is giving 17.17, austerity in mode of goodness, 17.18, austerity in mode of passion, 17.19, austerity in mode of ignorance, and you try to put forth in one picture, and this is that picture, which should really help us clarify our doubt and follow. And so that's why this chapter is division of faith. How the faith of the person is divided based on modes, based on his body habits, or his worshipability, his mind and his words. So Bhagavad Gita is actually a practical manual of life. So we already finished about what foods you have to eat in the mode of goodness, passion and ignorance just some time back, which I think I may have recorded it and uploaded it. But here, Krishna is very nicely explaining about a way of life, what you should eat, how you should do austerity, who you should worship, what should be your speaking habits, what should be what you should focus on in your mind. So this is a practical life lesson, and more we take to it is going to be beneficial. So today, it's about austerity in three modes. In the next verse, we're going to discuss another trait which Krishna is explaining in this chapter. So we can go on and on, but I would like to hear from you and your thoughts. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Hare Krishna. Anyone have any question, comments, reflections? Please go ahead and ask.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, nicely explained.
Hare Krishna.
Related to this one, may not be directly, but indirectly. So I was just listening a few days back to one class from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Prabhuji. So here, the thing where you have mentioned, Prabhuji, where it has been written, service should be done without expecting anything. So if anything is there, if any expectation is there, like ROI kind of thing, it is business, which is really true. So he was saying that even though you do not ask anything, even without asking anything, so that reciprocation from Krishna is always there. You start doing your service even if you are very starting process in Krishna consciousness. So Krishna sends his Sudarshan Chakra to protect you, even if you are not a devotee also. So even if you are not chanting 16 round, but still you are initiating in a very basic level of devotion. So he said that, okay, it means Krishna takes care of everything. So you need not have to have anything in mind like, I need this, I need that. Those things are already taken care. So you just engage in the service and without having any business mentality, he was saying.
Very nice, very nice. Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj is very potent soul in our movement. He is one of our top leaders. He has written a book called Basics of Bhagavad Gita. It's available in Amazon.in. Nowhere in that book there is his name. There he has taken the principles of Bhagavad Gita. It's a very small book. But Maharaj has, if you read that small book, it's recommended for all Bhakti Vriksha practitioners. Once upon a time, it was recommended for all the Bhakti Vriksha practitioners in Radha Gopinath temple in Chowpatty. Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj is a very exalted soul, and he is saying this with too much of with the right conviction. So yes, Krishna's devotees are always protected by himself, and Krishna releases his weapon, Sudarshan Chakra, to protect his devotees. So we sometimes we cannot understand because we do not have the right knowledge. We think this is a myth. That's why anything about Krishna, Ram, we call it mythological. But that's not fact. The fact is Krishna's Sudarshan Chakra came as a cloth for Mother Draupadi. It can come in any form or size. It can come in with, Krishna says, I am the cause of your remembrance. I am the cause of your forgetfulness. Sometimes whenever you are giving interview, sometimes something will click. And at that time, you'll realize Krishna has said in Bhagavad Gita that he is the cause of your forgetfulness, your remembrance. Most of the time, we don't recognize that our thought process, the neurons and how it works. And what in Bhagavad Gita, it's very clearly mentioned by Krishna that he protects us. So more and more, we focus our attention, stay with the confines of devotees. The benefit you are going to get is going to be perceived now, right in this life. And this life practices are very practical. So this is a transcendental science, as you said. Krishna is protecting us. Bhagavad Gita, at the end of Bhagavad Gita, what do our acharyas say? Chant. So many people say, you know, how is this chanting the holy name is so relevant to this complicated topic which was mentioned in a battlefield by Krishna to Arjuna? The reason why chanting is very important is going to give you focus. It's going to put your mind fixated on the principles laid out in Bhagavad Gita and not wander around like it is happening with so many other situations. So smaranam, chanting is a prayer. Chanting is smaranam. And more we increase our quality of chanting, our mind will become more and more peace at ourselves. And that is reflective in everywhere else, in your job, in your family life, in your volunteering life, in your game life, if you're playing any sports, it's fixed. So that is why Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj says that whoever does devotional service with the right mind, without expecting anything, Krishna's weapons protects them all the time. And Krishna is very protective, very dear to his devotees. And there are so many pastimes we can discuss, but thank you for bringing that up, Prabhu, and reposing that thought we all should have in Krishna consciousness process. Thank you. Any other comments, questions?
Prabhuji, I have just a question. I know, as you explained, there are different forms of austerity there. But does somebody need austerity or practice austerity to service the or devotional service or service of the Lord?
is it required? Somebody just chanting or somebody just doing a service, some kind of service. So where is the austerity? How much it is? Yes, is it essential? Yeah.
Right. So what is what happens is, Prabhu, we all have a lot of baggage. We have a lot of conditioning. We have grown up with a lot of anarthas. We did not know about these principles before. So we have so much of ahankar. We do a job which has brings in a lot of... So we have a lot of baggage. We have a lot of things which are not conducive for devotional service. So the austerity is an is a process by which we let these things go out of in our life. What happens is once you start doing devotional service in the form of, you know, washing utensils in the kitchen or cutting vegetables in the kitchen. So what you're doing is you're not thinking like a CEO. You're probably thinking like a servant of the Lord Jagannath or servant of Lord Krishna, a servant of Lord Gauranga. And you, at that level, you have left your position in your house or in your office. So that makes you, that level of getting rid of that me attitude, me, is actually relieving you from that load and getting you to a situation where you are more focused. So that is austerity, actually. For somebody like, for somebody who is very rich, trying to forget about his richness and coming to the temple and washing the utensils is a big thing, actually, in terms of crushing that ahankar. So it's all about consciousness, right? So the Krishna consciousness is all about our consciousness. Sometimes you have $1 million, you give away $1 million, you probably won't end up getting that much pious credits. If a person who is earning $100 a day and he gives $100 to the, he can basically get rid of that $100 from his life and system. That is considered because he has given up everything. So the thought process here is, it's not deity worship per se. It is our ability to see everything. This world is made by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There's beautiful land, water, mountains, but we never care for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sometimes when the April 15th comes, we run around to give taxes because these are the rules of the law, and immediately the rules of the law is going to take action on you if you don't file taxes. However, we take benefit of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, this Mother Nature, which he beautifully created in Bhagavad Gita. He mentioned that I have created this material nature, but we do not care. So when you do not care, you think there is no consequences, but there is, which Krishna consciousness tells us that we have to be caring. We have to be caring of this Mother Nature. So that's the reason why Krishna consciousness tries to make everybody a better human being, so that we stay focused on this creator. In Srimad Bhagavatam, there's Sarga, primary creation, Visarga, secondary creation, very nicely explained in Srimad Bhagavatam as to how this wonderful Mother Nature is created. So in that context, when you do devotional service, you're basically repaying that. So most of the time we think that you know, we do something good, we get something good, but once you enjoy it, that is gone. But by doing devotional service, what you're doing is you're getting rid of all this toxins from your body, like ahankar, pride, prajalpa, and then you get into an act of serving the devotees. When you serve the devotees, what happens is all this dirt, what we have, is gone. And now we feel much better. And you're serving who? The greatest person in the whole world, not some politician or not some group's president, this, that. So that is the reason why serving the devotees is the most satisfying experience. People in our temple have been, had many posts, but that didn't give them happiness. But when they're serving in the temple, that gives them the happiness, because in the consciousness, they're serving the greatest person of the whole world. Does that explain what you wanted to ask, Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhuji. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu, for contributing. Anybody else have any comments, reflections, any thought process about austerity and how austerity is not just standing in a leg or in yoga, putting our head upside down. Austerity is an ability or a thought process, a conscious thought process by which we have something and we have the chance to let it go, and we let it go. Not for the sake of any benefit, but the sake of meeting the scriptural injunctions, which is mentioned in the transcendental literature. Okay, so any other thoughts, any other additions you might like to add? So we have some new devotees joining us. So we welcome everyone. Please join regularly. But the thing is, there are some little announcements, because next Saturday, we have His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Swami Maharaj, who is a very exalted sannyasi in our movement. He's coming to our temple. His program is on Saturday evening in temple. So we'll not be having Bhakti Vriksha, but I will be posting the program details in this group. So please attend. Maharaj has written many books. You can take the books from his hand. He can sign it for you. He has written some very, very beautiful books. Srimati Radharani, Sri Khetra Parikrama, Jai Jagannath, Sri Jagannath, Sri Mandir, Navadi Parikrama, Narasimha, Who is God? Maya, beautiful books. And Maharaj is a great speaker as well. So hear him speak is a privilege. So attend that program. There'll be prasadam in the temple as well. And the next Saturday is the long weekend. Hopefully some of you are traveling, so we'll not have it. But I just wanted to lay it out that stay connected. And the next Saturday also we'll not have it, because it is going to be the Snan Yatra of the Lord of the Universe. But as long as you stay connected with the devotees, Bhakti Vriksha, Bhagavad Gita discussion will resume, because as this festivals are practical applications of Bhagavad Gita. As long as you're attending these wonderful events, it gives you that energy to kind of sort of foster your Krishna conscious life. Any comments, Prabhu? Any other thoughts? A very quiet audience most of the time. There's some questions. Any general topics you want to discuss? Any general questions you may have? Last week, we missed some of you.
Yes, Prabhuji, Hare Krishna. So thanks. I missed 2 weeks. So unfortunately, some of the, time-wish things came up. Unavoidable things. So that's a...
That's okay. Yeah, that's okay. I'm glad you're back, Prabhu. Niranjan Prabhu, Tralokya Prabhu, Rekha Mataji, anything you want to...
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Dandavatana.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
I missed the last class, and currently I'm driving, so yeah, nice class for me. So I don't want to miss, so I just muted and I listened the whole class.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you. Pratap Prabhu, you raised your hand.
Yeah, I just wanted to say one thing, Prabhuji. It has to be a fortune. A lot of fortune to be there to have an association, like this also. So when we miss it, so that's a kind of a, because of the wrong planning and so many other things. So I feel that means really we miss, maybe it is our misfortune that we miss the association. So But I do not know why exactly that happens, because even if we try to proceed in our devotion, Prabhuji, but still, even seeing that, sometimes I felt maybe we may have strived to do something, means whether it is a service or to be in certain class, but we miss it. So that is kind of our misfortune or something like that. So I realized two classes I missed, I felt that way, that okay, something is wrong. So that is happening. So yes, Prabhuji, means yeah. Missing this class is really, means I don't like it, but sometimes something happens, so somebody comes up, so I cannot see it, tell them to go away. So
right. That's absolutely understandable, because this is not an easy scenario, because you're basically, leaving your family commitments. So whatever you try, gradually, this will come out, and soon you'll realize that you're missing something. And as long as that feeling is prevailing in your mind, that means you're going in the right direction. So whenever you have fever, and when the fever reduces, it always reduces in the right direction. So once you have the yearning for the devotees, yearning for the association of devotees, and want to hear something transcendental, and you look for that opportunity to hear it, whether it is Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj you mentioned, or any of your familiar speakers, that means you are yearning for, your ear is yearning to hear something transcendental. That means your transformation is happening. So give more, you simmer your vegetables nicely, the sabji comes out very nicely. So let's not fast track it. Give the time, and that's going to be very beneficial. Okay. So Rohit Prabhu, you're doing all right?
Prabhuji, Hare Krishna. I joined a bit late, like 15, 20 minutes late. So I'd like to...
Yeah, I'd like to get your association more and more. Yeah. All right. Any other comments?
Prabhuji, Snana Jatra, then probably Bhakti Purushottam Swami will do it, Prabhuji?
No.
During that time, you will be
no.
there.
No, Prabhu. Bhakti Prasad Maharaj has plans on July 3rd. He's traveling away from okay. New Jersey. So he won't be with us during okay. Snana Yatra. Yeah, so what Maharaj, he comes for 1.5 months, 2 months. His program is very tight. He is coming all the way. He came, he went to Alaska, then he... went to Oregon, then he went to Dallas. Tomorrow he's going to be in Delaware, Baltimore. Then he's coming to Philadelphia, then Tobacco, New York, New Jersey. So, and in probably 2-3 more weeks, he'll go back to go back. So he won't be with us on June 3rd.
Prabhuji, it is June 3rd. Snadita is June 3rd, right?
Right, in the Panchang based on the New Jersey Times, it is on June 3rd. Yeah,
and that occur in the evening.
In the evening, we'll have Snana Yatra of the Lord Jagannath, followed by Hathi Vesh, Gajanan Vesh Darshan, and Chappan Bhog and Prasad Feast.
Okay, got it.
All right, so we'll end here. It was great connecting with devotees always. So let's all offer our obeisances at the lotus feet of all Vaishnavas by saying Vancha Kalpataru Vyasya Kripasindhu Vaivacha Patitanam Pavanevya Vaishnavevya Namo Namo Vaishnavarindha Ki Cha Granthraj Bhagavad Gita Ki Cha Shla Prabhupada Ki Cha Gaur Premanande Hari Hari
Bol.